Well, cracks seem to be only widening in the EPS-OPS camp with AIADMK's RK Nagar contestant E Madhusudhanan writing a scathing letter to the Tamil Nadu Chief Minister, blaming Tamil Nadu Minister Jayakumar for the party's RK Nagar poll loss. He alleges Jayakumar and other coordinators did not cooperate with him. Priyambata, this is E Madhusudhanan, the AIADMK veteran, once the party's presidium chairman, upset, fuming and making all the allegations against Mr. Jayakumar.
Absolutely, but we haven't got the copy of the letter, which Madhusudhanan is neither denying or accepting, but he does say that he has worked for the party for many, many years. Through sources, we have understood the content of the letter in which Madhusudhanan has raised 14 questions to the Tamil Nadu Chief Minister Edappadi Palaniswamy. He says that the OPS team has been constantly sidelined and OPS has not got a deserving position and the RK Nagar elections had to be lost by the AIADMK because there was no cooperation from the district secretaries and from Minister Jayakumar, who was in charge of a couple of booths. Madhusudhanan has alleged that the EPS has been, his government has been acting with an intention of sidelining OPS, and that's the reason why they were not able to win the RK Nagar elections, which has not only defamed Madhusudhanan but has defamed the legacy of MGR, Jayalalitha, and two leaf symbol, because RK Nagar has been a bastion. While talking to the media persons, Madhusudhanan said the rest of the questions have to be asked to Edappadi Palaniswamy, but he says that he will not reveal any of the details of the letter, which is a party secret, and they are trying to resolve the issue. Just a month back, we saw that AIADMK's Maitreyan had tweeted saying that the factions have united, but the hearts have not united. And Madhusudhanan has quoted that as well in the letter, saying that we were fuming when Maitreyan had given that tweet, but the reality is that we have not united, which the enemies are making use of.
Right. Priyambata, thanks for getting us all the updates on the letter sent in by E. Madhusudhanan to the party chief minister. But just stay on with me for the other news about the 100% salary hike. We're talking about the Tamil Nadu MLAs rewarding themselves with the 100% salary hike. In fact, the monthly salary and other allowances paid to every MLA in Tamil Nadu Assembly will now be increased from the existing 55,000 rupees to a whopping 1.05 lakh rupees. The state chief minister Edappadi K. Palaniswamy announced this during the last assembly session in July, and the bill was tabled today amid strong opposition from the DMK and the TTV camp. The hike could come into effect tomorrow only if the House passes the bill. This comes even as the state government has been claiming that they are under a lot of financial stress, thus rejecting a 2.57 hike proposed by the Transport Union, which has been on strike for a week now.
I don't like it. I don't want the rise because a lot of people after demonetization also, lot of financial problem, especially the government, Tamil Nadu government is suffering out of scarcity of money. They should not have increased it. It is a political decision in order to keep the MLAs who are supporting him. He is, in order to keep them happy, he is making all this.
We have protested before the Labour Commission office because they have not followed the procedure of the Industrial Dispute Act. So that we want to dispense that settlement and start the negotiation. And today the case has been posted in the special bench of the Madras High Court. We will see what the reply will come, what the decision will come, and then we will see in the evening.
Priyambata is with us. So Priyambata, 100% salary hike for the lawmakers of Tamil Nadu, but no money for the transporters and you know, no empathy to the people who have suffered as a result of the bus strike. How fair is this? The big question is whether the DMK and TTV Dinakaran stick to their stand and see that this bill is not passed tomorrow.
Well, obviously, they will stick to the stand, but then TTV Dinakaran is one MLA, and of course, DMK has got 98 MLAs along with the alliance partners. But people are the ones who are end of the day stranded, because as of now, at least with the 18 MLAs disqualified, there is a simple majority for the EPS government, which might pass this bill. I'm joined by some of the commuters who are really suffering. How difficult is it for you to commute every day with the bus strike? What is happening?
It's becoming very difficult. It's almost a week since the strike has started. There are buses, private buses which are running, but again they are charging very heavy price for it. Also the cab operators are charging hefty amount for the for a short distance travel. Ultimately, we the common man is the main suffering because of all this.
Absolutely. What do you think of MLAs getting a pay hike from 55,000 to a whopping 1.05 lakh? But you and I have to really suffer without buses and paying extra for the cab.
Actually, from last Wednesday, this strike is happening and none of the political parties are not serious about this. So this is because of not the because they are not seeing because one union is running the bus and some of the unions are not running the bus. It's actually the public is not been completely suffered. So that's why still as of now that they think that, okay, some of the buses running and some of the buses not running.
Right.
But actually they must think seriously about that and they must be united and they must do something. And because MLAs are getting 100% hike, why can't they do something for the public?
Absolutely. People have to get something. How, I mean, you are a college student and how was the commutation? What do you, how do you have to spend extra money?
Yeah, definitely, you know, it's really difficult for those college students, especially in school goers, and they are their halfway examinations coming up, and it's really difficult for us to travel. You know, like these transport workers are staging their protest for 1 week, and the government hasn't taken any decision yet.
And also, the transport workers are asking only for 0.18%.
Yeah, it, I think that government should take some step to, you know, honor this, or they should talk and they should resolve this, because, you know, it's very difficult for a common man to, you know, travel on the roads now because we don't have buses. The peak hours are jam-packed and there's no cabs available.
No cabs available. It's really, really becoming tough here for the commuters and the passengers, but the government is not taking note.
Absolutely. Priyamvata, thank you so much for joining us. We'll keep coming back to you for further inputs and updates on the bus strike. Meanwhile, the Madras High Court is also likely to give its verdict today in the disqualification of the 18 AIADMK MLAs. Along with the writ petitions of the 18 MLAs from the estranged TD Vidyanarkaran camp, High Court will jointly hear DMK leader Stalin's plea to conduct a trust vote for the Chief Minister. The verdict will not only determine the fate of the 18 MLAs, but will also significantly impact the political landscape of the state. Tamil Nadu Speaker Dhanapal disqualified the 18 MLAs supporting TD Vidyanarkaran. These MLAs had submitted letters to the governor stating that they had lost complete faith in the Chief Minister. The Speaker's move was then immediately challenged by the MLAs in the High Court. And if the High Court does cancel the disqualification, the OPS-EPS camp might not be able to garner the majority mark in the Assembly in the crucial floor test. And now we will go straight to Chitradurga in Karnataka, where the BJP President Amit Shah is addressing the Parivartan Yatra just months ahead of the Karnataka Assembly elections. Let's listen in.
ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಂತ್ರಿ ಮಂಡಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರು ಮಂತ್ರಿಯಾಗಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಮುಂದುವರಿತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ? ಸಿಟಿ ಎಂಆರ್ಐಕೆ ಲೇಬ್ ಲಗಾನೆ ಕಾ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಅಪ್ನೆ ರಿಶ್ತೇದಾರೋ ಕೋ ದೇ ದೇತೇ ಹೇ ಎಂಆರ್ಐ ಸ್ಕ್ಯಾನಿಂಗ್ ನ ಅದನ್ನ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಗಳ ಸಂಬಂಧಿಕರಿಗೆ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಗಳ ಮಗರಿಗೆ ಕೊಡುವಂತ ವ್ಯವಹಾರ ನಡೆಯುತ್ತೆ. ಅಪ್ನೆ ಪರಿವಾರ ವಾಲೋ ಕೋ ಪಿಡಿಎ ದ್ವಾರಾ 150 करोड़ रुपए की भूमि इरेग्युलर तरीके से दे देते हैं और संबंधित करके बीडीए मुखातर 1.5 2000 कोटि रूपये लैंड ಅವರಿಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಮಾಡಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಮಾರ್ಕಬಾ ಕೆನಾಲ್ इसके आधुनिकीकरण में 900 करोड़ रुपया से ज्यादा घोटाला होता है. ಮಲಪ್ರಭಾ ಯೋಜನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ 900 ಕೋಟಿ ರೂಪಾಯಿಗಳ ಅವ್ಯವಹಾರ ನಡೆಯುತ್ತೆ. ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಬ್ರಿಜ್ ಮಾನ್ಯತೆ ಅಪ್ರೂವಲ್ ಕೆ ಲಿಯೆ 100 ಕರೋಡ್ ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಮಾಂಗಾ ಜಾತಾ ಹೇ. ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಬ್ರಿಜ್ ನ ಒಪ್ಪಂದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಅನುಮತಿಗಾಗಿ 100 ಕೋಟಿ ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಲಂಚವನ್ನ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ.
ಗೋವಿಂದ ರಾಜ್ ಕಿ ಡೈರಿ ಅಗರ್ ಖುಲೆ ಏಕ್ ಸಪ್ತಾಹ ತಕ್ ಮೇ ಪಡ್ ಜಾವು ಇತ್ನಾ ಭ್ರಷ್ಟಾಚಾರ ಇಸ್ಕೆ ಅಂದರ್ ಫೈಲಾ ಹುವಾ.
ಗೋವಿಂದ ರಾಜನ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿರೋ ಡೈರಿಯನ್ನು ನಾನು ತೆಗೆದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಒಂದು ವಾರದವರೆಗೆ ನಾನು ಓದಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಪ್ರಮಾಣದ ಭ್ರಷ್ಟಾಚಾರ ಈ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಅದರಲ್ಲಿದೆ.
1800 तालाब डीनोटिफाइड कर दिए है, मछुआरे किसानों की चिंता नहीं की, 1800 केरे डीनोटिफिकेशन मारतारे, अलिर्तकंत मीनगारे वंचने 300 मेगावाट सोलर पावर में उसमें भी घुस ली गई, सोलार ना 300 कोटी रूपये सोलार ना योजना कूड़ा लंचद व्यवहार नड़ीयते। मित्रों मेरे पास सूची तो बड़ी लंबी है, ನನ್ನ ಹತ್ರ ಬಹಳ ಭ್ರಷ್ಟಾಚಾರ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಪಟ್ಟಿನೇ ಇದೆ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಸರ್ಕಾರದ್ದು, ಮಗರ್ ಮೇ ಪೂರಿ ಸೂಚಿ ಪಡನೆ ಜಾಂಗಾ ನಾ ತೋ 7 ದಿನ ಕಿ ಭಗವತ್ ಶಬ್ದ ಬಿಠಾನಿ ಪಡೆಗಿ, ನಾನು ಎಲ್ಲ ಓದಕ್ಕೆ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 7 ದಿವಸದ ಭಗವದ್ಗೀತೆ ಕಥನ ಹೇಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು, ಕತೆ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು, ಹಂಗ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನನ್ನ ಹತ್ರ ಮಾಹಿತಿಗಳು ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಸರ್ಕಾರದಿದೆ, ಮಗರ್ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಜೊ ಹೇ ಉಸ್ಕೆ ಪೇಟ್ ಕಾ ಪಾನಿ ನಹಿ ಈ ಸರ್ಕಾರಕ್ಕೆ, ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಏನಿದೆ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನೀರಿಲ್ಲದೆ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತ ಮಟ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಇವತ್ತು ಅವರು ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮಿತ್ರರು ಭಾರತೀಯ ಜನತಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿ ಔರ್ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಸ್ವಯಂಸೇವಕ ಸಂಘಕ್ಕೆ 20 ಜ್ಯಾದಾ ಕಾರ್ಯಕರ್ತಾವ್ ಕಿ ಹತ್ಯಾ ತೀನ್ ಸಾಲ್ ಕೆ ಅಂದರ್ ಕರ್ ದಿ ಗೈ ಹೈ. ಮಿತ್ರರೇ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾರತೀಯ ಜನತಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಯ ಕಾರ್ಯಕರ್ತರನ್ನ, ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಸ್ವಯಂ ಸೇವಕ ಸಂಘದ ಕಾರ್ಯಕರ್ತರನ್ನ ಕಳೆದ 3 ವರ್ಷದಲ್ಲಿ 23 ಜನರನ್ನ ಕೊಲ್ಲುವಂತ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಈ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಮಾಡಿದೆ.
ಉಂಟಾ ಗುಣಾ ಕ್ಯಾ ಥಾ, ಉಂಟಾ ದೋಷ ಕ್ಯಾ ಥಾ,
ಅವರ ತಪ್ಪೇನಿದೆ, ಅವ್ರು ಏನ್ ತಪ್ಪು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ,
ಅವರೇ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಇಸ್ಕಿ ಜಾಂಚ್ ಭೀ ನಹಿ ಕರ್ ರಹಿ ಹೈ,
ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅಲ್ಲ ಈ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಅದರ ತನಿಖೆಯನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ.
ಮಿತ್ರೋ ಮೇ ಕಹನಾ ಚಾಹತಾ ಹೂ, हमारे कार्यकर्ताओं पर अत्याचार बंद कर दीजिए, इस सरकार का आयुष्य लंबा नहीं है, जब भाजपा सरकार आएगी जेल के पीछे जाने की सब तैयारी कर दीजिए.
ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದೀನಿ ಬಂಧುಗಳೇ, ಈ ಕೊಲೆಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡೋದನ್ನ ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸಿ, ಈ ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಆಯುಷ್ಯ ಬಹಳ ದಿನ ಇಲ್ಲ, 3-4 ತಿಂಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಬದಲಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಬದಲಾಗಿ ಬರುವಂತ ಬಿಜೆಪಿ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಆ ರೀತಿ ಕೊಲೆಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥವ್ರನ್ನ ಜೈಲ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಅಟ್ಟುವಂತ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನ ನಾವು ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ.
ಏ ಜೋ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಹೈ ವೋ ವೋಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಕಿ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಕರ್ ರಹಿ ಹೈ, ಏ ಜೋ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಹೈ ಯೇ ಹಿಂದೂ ವಿರೋಧಿ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಹೈ,
ಈ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ವೋಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ನ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಮತ ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಳ್ಳೋಕೋಸ್ಕರ ರಾಜಕಾರಣವನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಆ ರಾಜಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೆ ಈ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಮುಂದಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ.
ಈ ಸರ್ಕಾರ SDPI ನಾಮಕ್ಕೆ देश विरोधी संगठन का, फंडामेंटलिस्ट संगठन का सारे केस वापिस ले लिए.
ಈ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಮತಾಂಧ SDPI ಮೇಲಿರತಕ್ಕಂತ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕೇಸ್ಗಳನ್ನು ವಾಪಸ್ ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಂಡಿದೆ.
ಗಣೇಶ ಚತುರ್ಥಿ ಕೆ ಲಿಯೆ ಪಂಡಾ ಲಗಾನಾ ಹೋತಾ ಹೈ ತೋ 10 ಲಾಖ ಕಾ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಮಾಂಗಾ ಜಾತಾ ಹೈ,
ಗಣೇಶ ಚತುರ್ಥಿಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಈ ಹಾಕುವಂತ.
And with that, we're heading into a short break. A quick reminder, you can always stay updated by logging on to our website, indiatoday.in. You can catch all the news that you missed, or you could also download the India Today app. A short break, I'll be back in just a bit.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel, We Know You Will Love To.